Here's the wheel, and as you can see, this is an assembly, so we'll put the assembly within an assembly, that'll mean. And we've got two parts here, we've got the wheel and we've got the tire. It's sometimes really useful to do this when you've got, these are called sub-assemblies, so if you've got something like a wheel, it's always good to assemble it, so therefore it means that we don't have to keep adding and lining up the wheel and the wheel centre time after time. So we've got the wheel, and then we go file, open, and the last but not least, we'll just go part back to parts of solid car, is the steering wheel. So again, the steering wheel has been put together in an assembly. So I open that up, there we go, there's our steering wheel, and as we can see, all the different parts to the steering wheel. So we can see our feature tree here, the creation of that. So I'll minimise that. Now, if we go along here, if we go down into my Solidworks car file, back into it, and we go into insert components again, notice that all the files that we brought up here are now available to bring in. Okay, cool. So now we are ready to assemble our car. So green tick. Okay, the first part we're going to bring in is going to be our floor brick. Okay, so but when we bring this in, we want to go up to view first, and so that we can see the origins, view origins. Okay, so view origins, and notice this blue parts part, because basically what we want to do is align the origin from the floor brick up with the origin of the assembly. So hang on, I can right click, if I get that wrong I can just delete that, yes, and go back to insert component, floor brick, and then if I click near the origin, notice how the two origins snap together, and there we go, that's what I wanted. Now this part, if I try and move it, isn't movable, whereas if I bring my next part in, which will be, I'll bring my back brick in, notice that we can actually move it around and around. Okay, so the first part you always bring in is always what's called fixed, and if you right click on it, you can actually unfix it by going down here to float, or I'm going to keep it fixed, so right click fix, but that's just telling you guys, keep it fixed for now. But yeah, so it's important. So now we've got our first part in, and if you click on it, hold it down, you can move it round. You can remember move around by holding down the middle mouse button or zoom in and out, so it's a lot easier to see. This is really useful for assemblies. Okay, now we're ready to use the mate tool. So what I want to basically happen is this to align with this, this to align with this, and then this bottom here needs to align with this, if you can imagine it touching in real life. How do we do that? We use this paperclip up here called the mate tool. So we mate, click mate there, and we've got all our different types of mates. If we select two, generally SolidWorks will automatically create a mate. So like if I select this and here, notice that it's selected coincident, and that's correct for that, so I can green tick that. Then if I select that and that, we want the same again, coincident, correct, green tick that. Now we're just going to bring it down, so if I click here and here and we green click coincidence, now that's gone. Now notice we've got two parts in here. If I try to move this part now, it's fixed because we've added mates to it, it's fixed to this part, so it won't move. And if we want to change any of those mates, down here we've got a little section called mates, so we can right click on any of them if you want to tune and go edit feature, not that I want to, and you can change it in there. But I mean, you might want to add a distance of say 10 mil, so look, or we just might want to have it coincident. That's fine for now anyway. Okay, so that's all good. Now we can start to bring in our other parts using the same technique. So again, I'll go insert component. Now I'll go to front brick. I'll insert that. Right, okay, what I do like to tend to do as well is before I will add any of the mates, I'll realign this component so it's just roughly in the correct position. So I'll go up here, move component, click down, rotate component first around like so, and that will be a lot nicer to position in basically. So now we go to mate again, I'll click that side and that side, coincident, green tick, that front, that front. Look, and it automatically moves it, which is really nice. Solidworks, green tick, and that part, and that part there, and we'll green tick that. Now we've got the base ready for our Solidworks part. Now we're ready to bring in, first of all, we can either bring in, let's bring in the steering wheel. So if we go down to steering wheel down here, click on that, again using the same techniques, click this edge and here. Oh look, and it's actually aligned the wrong way, which can be a bit of a pain sometimes, but over here we've got the flip mate alignment tool, so if we click this, it will align the different way. So remember, clicking this on and off will align it differently. So that's correct. Now green tick that, there, we'll go there, like so. And then the final one is to bring this down to here and green tick that. We can still see all our origins right now, so it's best to just turn them off. We'll go view again and click off on origins. There we go. Nice. Now ready to bring our wheel chassis in. Okay, so there's, we need two of these, so I'll go insert one component, click on wheel chassis, drag across, click in the screen and bring another one across. Now we're ready to make these up. So first of all, we will click on here and make that with this side here. There we go, that's nice. Green tick that, and we'll click this front can be in line with here, there, like so. And then the final one will be click on here, click on this bottom part, like so. Right, if you do get one wrong, say for instance on that last one, if I'd accidentally clicked there, and hang on, I'll just pull that component out again. So look, that component can only move along there. So if I'd accidentally done like so, hang on, I'll right click on here, clear selections. If I had clicked there and there, I got it wrong and I knew that, then it's not a problem. I can just right click in here, go clear selections, and move this down. Oops, I'll click out of that first. And I'll just go back mate, click there, and there. Green tick that. And then for the last one, we'll click on the back bit, on that bit, around, green tick there, and then this side to align with this side, green tick, and then that base to align with that base, green tick. So if we do remember all of our mates down here, if you get one terribly wrong, right click on it, just click delete, and that will get rid of the mate. You can just do it, redo it over again. So now we've got all we're ready to do now, there's one last thing, is insert and put our wheels onto the car. So we go down, select wheel, I'm going to drag four of these in, insert component, wheel, there, insert component, wheel, there, insert component, wheel, there, okay. Now we've got ready to bring our wheels in. Okay, so we'll go mate again. This time, instead of using faces, we're going to use this part here. So if I hover over there, cylinder and that cylinder, so look what happens now, those cylinders will align. So basically what it means is that wheel is going along like so, and then I want to mate that face with this face here, like so. And we're going to go round and just repeat that process. So inner there, there, and that face, and that face, green tick. Now again, what I said that I like to do before is we'll just rotate these by going up to move component, we'll rotate these around. Okay, so what you've got to do though, so every time you set it, make sure you green tick out. Okay, so no, that's wrong, move component, rotate component, make sure you can, yeah, there we go. Right, they're roughly in the right position now. I go mate again, select the inner there, align it. That face there, and that face there. There we go. So, there, and there, and we're aligning. And then there, and right, that's a bit difficult to get to. So what I can do is just drag that out. Okay, and then I go mates. Oops, right click, clear selection. And there. Green tick. Right, ta-da. Now, if I go there, there we can see car is done. And as you can see, like all the colours, because we've added colours before, they're brought across with the parts, which is really nice. I'm just going to show you a little trick. It's really quick and easy to do using another program quickly called Solidworks Photo View. So if I just save this part now, so we've saved our toy car. Right, now down and go to File, Open, Photo View 360. This is what's called rendering, so we can make something look really nice. It's really simple, just uses this. Right, so it opens up now, and we can just literally go up in, open the file, and wait 1 second for it to load up. Okay, and we'll find our file. So if we go desktop, SolidWorks car, then we go to the select the SolidWorks toy car assembly, open. This is just, you don't have to do this, guys, it's just showing you a little bit about what we can do. And there's our part file, and we can just, I'll just do this, the settings to be really quite low, so right there. And what we can do is then go final render, and what this will quickly do, so we just render our car, so we can get a nice image out of it, whether that be to show clients or even for presentation in your work. So just bear with me a second. So this takes a little while to do, but should be done pretty quick. For the block colours, it's generally faster, and then the areas where there's different variations, such as there, right there, it takes a little longer, but as I say, shouldn't take too long at all to do. And then we can just output this as a JPEG image and input it into our work as a nice presentation tool. It's just quickly, so I go file, save image, and we can save it into desktop in our file where we created our SolidWorks car. So I mean, that's a really quick overview. That'll be explained in more depth than later on. But that's why it's good to add colours early on. So we've done that. And that completes the SolidWorks tutorial for the creation of a little toy car.